Hi everybody, my name is Tara Jarrett. I use she, her pronouns, and I'm an outdoor educator with Metro. Today we are at Smith & Bybee Wetlands in honor of World Turtle Day this week. Turtles I wanted to talk about today include Western Painted Turtles, Western Pond Turtles, and Red-Eared Sliders. The first two that I mentioned are actually native to Oregon, and the third is an invasive species that you may find here in the park. I brought along to show you guys today some natural artifacts about turtles and show you what makes up a turtle. So I have a shell here, and the common myth is that turtles can actually come out of their shells. That's not true. The shell is an integrated part of the turtle. It's actually made out of bone and covered in these little colorful scutes that are decorated in lines and markings. Those scutes are made out of keratin, which is the same stuff that makes our hair and our nails. And integrated into the turtle is its spine, and it actually connects to the bottom here. So inside of a turtle shell, all of its organs live and provide lots of protection for predators that may come in the wild. So hawks, sometimes even bullfrogs, raccoons, all of those sorts of species will come after turtles, young and old, and especially the eggs. Smith & Bybee is really special because it provides perfect habitat for these turtles that require both an open wetland and also some forested area. Turtles rely on grassy, protected areas to dig shallow nests where they may deposit their eggs. I have here some eggshells that are all kind of rolled up because turtle eggs are soft. They're not like bird eggs where they're hard and crunchy, but they're actually more leathery. And once the turtle hatches, come September time, these shells will harden up and roll up and kind of turn into what you see here. So a really good place to see turtles here at Smith & Bybee Park is actually right here at a place called Turtle Turnout. You'll see lots of open water and logs where these turtles can bask and collect that energy from the sun because they are cold-blooded. They'll also process vitamin D through their shells, and once they're all powered up and ready to go, this is a really good place for them to hunt for small insects or fish, sometimes even tadpoles. Adult turtles will rely more on vegetation, like plants and roots to eat and collect energy out in the wild. A really good way to be able to tell the difference between a red-eared slider and a western painted turtle will be the markings that you see. So a western painted turtle along the sides and bottom of the shell are bright red and very colorful. The bottom you might not see so much, but look around the edges of the shell where you can see that colorful red and orange patterning. Their heads will actually be a very dark color. As opposed to red-eared sliders, known for that red ear, there'll be a big red mark on the side of their face. This is the western pond turtle. This one's also native. You can see those dull colorations, and this one is the biggest. So if you find a big, dull turtle, probably a western pond turtle. If you see one that has that red spot on its eye, that one is a red-eared slider. And if you see ones that have beautiful red markings along the edges and backs and bottoms of their shells, those ones will be the native western painted turtles. Native plants are a great way to protect turtles this World Turtle Day. They rely on those indigenous plants, native plants, that don't take up too much room to have those grassy open areas to make their nests. A lot of introduced or invasive species will take up all that open land, make it really hard for the turtles to find a good spot. So plant lots of native plants. Dogs will often sniff out turtles and can destroy nests and even kill turtles by breaking their shells. So keeping dogs out of wetlands and areas where turtles call home is a really good way to protect them. And red-eared sliders are one of those species that we have here in Oregon so much because people love them as pets. Then they release them into the wild when they don't want to take care of them anymore or can't. And they actually compete for space and food and push out these indigenous species, which is why you see them in places like this. So keep your pets at home, don't release your pets into the wild, and plant lots of native species this World Turtle Day. Thanks for joining me at Smith & Bybee Wetlands. I hope you get to come out soon and check out the wildlife. Have a great day.